Okay, so picture this. You're scrolling through your, you know, your favorite online store, right about to hit add to cart for that thing you've been wanting.
Right.
But hold on a sec. Have you ever, like, stopped to think about the wild journey that product took to get there?
Yeah.
I'm talking about massive container ships,
mm-hmm.
the often invisible workhorses of global trade.
Right.
And let me tell you, these ships, these steel behemoths, they sometimes have a tendency to, well, burst into flames.
Yeah.
That's right, we're diving deep into the world of container ship fires today. A surprisingly common and surprisingly dangerous phenomenon.
It's funny you mentioned that add to cart moment, because that's where most of us connect with this vast global network.
Totally.
Without even realizing it. We click,
yeah.
we wait, we
yeah.
get our package. But behind that seemingly simple transaction is a complex system that most of us never think twice about.
Yeah.
Until something goes wrong, that is.
Exactly. And today's deep dive is all about uncovering one of those something wrong scenarios. A hidden vulnerability in our hyper-connected world that could impact everything from what's on store shelves to, believe it or not, the health of our oceans.
It could.
And to guide us through this fiery maze, we're tapping into the expertise shared by the folks over at Aviation and Nautical Masters on YouTube.
Okay.
They break this whole thing down in a way that's both fascinating and a little terrifying.
Yeah, it is. It is a bit of a wake-up call. Most people don't realize how often these container ship fires are actually happening.
Right.
And it's not just a few isolated incidents. It's a trend that's been ticking steadily upward over the past decade. Seriously, that many. What's driving this increase? Are we shipping more flammable cargo than ever before, or are there other factors at play here?
That's the million-dollar question. And as with most complex issues, it's rarely just one thing.
Right.
One factor is the sheer volume of goods being shipped. Global trade has exploded in recent years, and with it, the number of container ships plying the seas.
Yeah, man. That makes sense.
More ships, unfortunately, mean more opportunities for things to go wrong.
For sure.
But it's not just about the numbers. The type of cargo plays a role as well.
So we are shipping more flammable stuff these days.
Not necessarily more flammable, but the way it's being shipped is a cause for concern.
Okay.
There's been a rise in the misdeclaration of dangerous goods.
This means that cargo containing flammable or hazardous materials isn't always properly labeled or stored, increasing the risk of accidents. It's a recipe for disaster.
Wow.
And to add fuel to the fire, so to speak.
Literally.
There's also the issue of inadequate safety procedures and poorly maintained equipment.
So you're telling me that these floating cities, packed to the brim with who knows what, might not have all their safety ducks in a row?
That's a simplified way of putting it, but essentially, yes.
Okay, hold on. Before we go any further, can we talk about some real-world examples? I feel like we need to ground this in reality for a second. The YouTube video mentioned the MSC Flamina and the Maersk Konam. What happened there?
Both of those incidents involved major container ship fires that caused significant damage, and tragically, in the case of the Maersk Konam, loss of life. These weren't just small fires either. We're talking massive infernos, engulfing entire sections of these ships, causing millions of dollars in damage, disrupting global supply chains, and in the case of the Maersk Konam, tragically claiming the lives of 5 crew members.
Oh man.
These are the stark realities of what happens when things go wrong on these massive vessels.
Okay, that's sobering.
Yeah.
So we're not just talking about a few, you know, scorched shipping containers here.
Right.
We're talking about potential human tragedies.
Yeah.
Environmental catastrophes waiting to happen and disruptions to the global supply chain that we all rely on.
Yeah.
Right.
This is way bigger than I initially realized.
Mm.
But let's circle back to something you mentioned earlier, safety regulations.
Right.
I mean, these ships are basically floating cities. Aren't there, like, strict rules in place to prevent this kind of thing?
You'd think so, right?
Yeah.
But the reality is a bit more complicated.
Okay.
You see, the shipping industry has historically been, shall we say, a bit more relaxed when it comes to fire safety regulations compared to, say, the airline industry.
Wait, really? I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around that.
Yeah.
Why the difference?
Well, for a long time, the dangers of container ship fires weren't fully understood or appreciated.
Okay.
And with the industry's focus on efficiency and cost cutting,
right,
safety measures sometimes took a back seat.
Really?
It was a bit of a don't rock the boat mentality, so to speak.
Yikes. So for a long time, it was kind of a free-for-all on the high seas.
To a certain extent, yes, but here's the thing. It's not like there were NO regulations at all. In fact, there are international regulations known as SOLAS.
Okay.
Which stands for Safety of Life at Sea.
Gotcha.
These regulations cover a wide range of safety measures on ships, including fire safety.
Okay, so there were rules, but it sounds like there are some pretty significant gaps in those rules, or at least in how they were enforced.
Exactly.
Okay.
One of the biggest challenges with SOLAS regulations is that they're well international.
Makes sense.
That means that while they set a baseline for safety standards, the actual implementation and enforcement of those standards can vary widely from country to country.
Oh, wow.
And even from port to port.
So a ship flying a flag of convenience from a country with more lax regulations might be able to get away with cutting corners on safety measures.
That's one way to look at it. And even when regulations are in place, the sheer complexity of these ships and the challenges of inspecting them thoroughly can make enforcement tricky.
So it's like trying to regulate a small city that's constantly on the move.
Yeah.
I imagine that's not easy.
You got it.
Okay.
It's a complex issue with no easy answers.
So we've got a perfect storm brewing here.
Yeah.
Increasing cargo volume, inadequate safety protocols, lax regulations, and the challenges of enforcement on a global scale.
Right.
It's no wonder these fires are happening.
Yeah.
But let's go back to the Mars Konam incident for a moment.
Okay.
That one really hit home the human cost of these disasters.
Right.
What specific lessons did we learn from that tragedy?
The Mars Konam was a wake-up call for the industry, highlighting the potentially catastrophic consequences of these fires and the urgency of improving safety measures. The investigation into the incident revealed a cascade of errors, from mislabeling of dangerous goods to inadequate fire suppression systems.
So a whole series of unfortunate events all piling up to create the perfect conditions for disaster.
Precisely.
Wow.
The Maersk Konam tragedy forced the industry to confront some uncomfortable truths about its safety practices.
What's fascinating to me, and I'm sure to our listener as well, is that this isn't some abstract, far-off problem.
Right.
This directly impacts all of us.
Yeah.
Our stuff comes on these ships.
You're absolutely right. This isn't just an industry issue, it's a consumer issue.
Right.
When a container ship catches fire, it can disrupt global supply chains, leading to shortages and higher prices for consumers.
Totally.
Remember the supply chain chaos we saw during the pandemic? Imagine that amplified.
Oh, wow.
And then there's the environmental impact to consider.
Right.
These ships are carrying massive amounts of fuel and often hazardous materials.
Right.
When those go up in flames or spill into the ocean, it's an ecological nightmare.
Without a doubt.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've established that this is a serious problem with far-reaching consequences.
Hmm.
What's being done about it?
Yeah.
Are there any glimmers of hope on the horizon? So are there any glimmers of hope on the horizon, or are we doomed to a future of floating infernos and disrupted supply chains?
It's not all doom and gloom, thankfully. The good news is that the Maersk Konam tragedy, as devastating as it was, served as a major wake-up call.
Okay.
It forced the industry regulators and even consumers to start taking this issue much more seriously.
So what are we seeing in terms of like actual changes? Are there any new regulations or technologies that are making a difference?
There are some positive developments. For one, the SOLAS regulations, while imperfect, have been strengthened in recent years with a greater emphasis on fire safety measures for container ships.
Okay.
There's also been a push for better training and equipment for firefighting at sea, as well as improved systems for tracking and identifying dangerous goods.
So more stringent regulations,
yeah.
Better training, and improved technology for tracking hazardous materials. That all sounds promising. But is it enough?
That's the big question. While these are all steps in the right direction, the challenge remains. Implementation and enforcement on a global scale. The shipping industry is notoriously complex with many different players and interests involved.
Okay, so there's still work to be done.
Yeah.
But this is where we as consumers come in, right? We have a role to play in pushing for greater transparency and accountability in the industry.
Absolutely. As consumers, we wield enormous power.
That's right.
We can choose to support companies that prioritize safety and sustainability in their shipping practices. We can demand greater transparency about where our products are coming from and how they're being transported. And we can use our voices to advocate for stricter regulations and better enforcement.
So it's about making informed choices, both as consumers and as citizens.
Precisely. Every time we click add to cart, we're casting a vote for a certain kind of world, a certain way of doing business.
Yeah.
By understanding the risks involved in global trade and demanding better from the companies we support, we can help create a safer, more sustainable future for everyone.
That's a powerful message. It's a reminder that even in a globalized world, our individual actions can make a difference.
They absolutely can.
Well, this deep dive has definitely opened my eyes to a whole new level of complexity behind those add to cart buttons. I'll never look at a shipping container the same way again.
And that's the point, isn't it? To understand the often hidden connections between our choices and their impact on the world around us.
Couldn't have said it better myself. So to our listener, next time you're waiting for that package to arrive, take a moment to think about the journey it took to get there. Think about the ships, the crews, the regulations, the risks, and yes, even the potential for fires. And then ask yourself, what can I do to make this system safer and more sustainable? Because every choice, no matter how small, has the potential to make a difference. Thanks for joining us for this fiery deep dive. And until next time, keep exploring, keep questioning, and keep learning.